I believe you're talking about the impurities and najasa, and al-hadd al-ma'fu anhu, the amount which is pardoned of the najasa, which is called an insignificant amount of impurity, like the fingernail or something that in order to see it you have to focus on it and pay close attention to it, something insignificant, it is pardoned. So if after you pray or in the beginning of the prayer, even before you pray, you saw that, it is pardoned, versus whenever it is a big patch in your clothes, then you cannot actually pray with this kind of impurity. Then comparing the impurity, which is the blood or the pus, to an impurity that is coming because a dog licked or touched a part of the cloth, there is no comparison. In this case, the impurity which resulted in because of the licking of a dog must be washed 7 times, whether it is a small area or a big area. You don't have to wash the entire thawb, but at least the part of the clothes which have been contaminated with the impurities. And when we say الحد المعفو عن, it doesn't mean that you don't have to wash it off, you don't have to clean it up. But we keep in mind, sometimes you're out, you're shopping, and it is the prayer time. And if you were to wait until you go home and you remove the impurity, then that means you will miss one or two or more of the prayers. So can I pray with this little bit of impurity, which is less than approximately 1 centimeter or so? Yes, it is permissible to offer the prayer with such insignificant impurity or small impurity on one's clothes. But once I have an access to wash it off and clean up my thawb, one should do that. Obviously, according to other madahib, Imam Hanifa, for instance, is talking about as long as it is the size of a dirham or the silver coin. So the size of the insignificant impurities vary from madhab to another. But once I have an access to wash it off, clean it up, and remove it, I should do that.